Hello, everyone. Welcome to Drafting with Jamie Rigotti for ChannelFireball.com. Today we're doing a draft, of course. Throne of Eldraine. Let's do this. All right, so pack one, pick one. I'm looking at Fairy of Vandal, Sir Alan, Bake into a Pie. I think those are the only choices, really. I think Sir Alan's very strong. Is he a bomb? So I think it's between these two. Vandal is great, though. Oh, my gosh. I'm going to take the Sir Alan. Although, this is the only black card in the pack. I changed my mind. Dang it. Sorry, real quick. I was like, I think it's going to take the Bake because there's only one black card. There still is. Okay. I could still cut black, but black-white is not really where I want to be. It's not where I want to be, y'all. It's just not. So if I had taken Sir Alan, I'd be taking the Archon here. That's such a good card. I still might take it, but Red Cap Melee is ridiculous. There's a lot of good red in this pack. So that's a little scary. I don't think red's going to be super open in the next pack because there's some really, really, really strong red here. But my goodness. All right, so I'm going to pretend I don't have the Bake. Would I take the Archon? Probably. I don't know. The red is strong, though. The red is very strong. Oh, I'll take the Archon. I feel like everybody's going to fight over the red. Archon number two. All right. I'm in for it. Look at that Dance of the Man, so that's beautiful. You can actually make that work in Limited. I'm just not sure if I'm up for the challenge right now. You need a lot of eggs to make that work. I think I want the second Archon. I do. I'm probably not going to be black-white, though. Like, I've never actually had a good black-white deck, so Bacon's probably going to just get thrown aside. Okay, so Grimgoalie is amazing. But I'm very far away from that. So I'm looking at Venerable Knight or Reaper. Maybe Seven Dwarves? I mean, that seems odd, but, like, if I get in now, I could be, like, a nice Boros beatdown deck with these Archons. So I think that is a consideration, but I'm going to take the Venerable Knight here. Pathfinder, okay. So it seems like white is open, which is not unreasonable. People still don't like it. I mean, this is late. So I'm going to snatch that up. At its worst, it's a 2-2 flyer for 3. I'll take a Windrake. Whatever, sure. And I got some time to pick up some Guide Mothers. So I think that's the pick. There might be an argument for egg, maybe. It does keep you open, but I'm pretty sure I'm white at this point. I'm just sad I didn't take Sir Alan, pack one, pick one. I took the Bake! Because last second I was like, there's only one black card, let's do it. But the black is not flowing, so that did not pay off. Wondermare? I could spec on that. I could try to be Green-White Adventures, but honestly, that's pretty tough to get into on Modo. So I'm not sure that I'm going to do that. Plus, that's not really the payoff that I want in Green White Adventures. I want, like, an Innkeeper, which isn't a payoff, it's an Enabler. But that's what I really want in my Adventure deck. Wondermare's just alright. I don't think it's a reason to force Adventures, though. I think I'm just gonna take Youthful Knight. Cut white really hard, try to get a lot of white in the next pack. Like, I know I have a Pathfinder. I know that. But I have no Adventure cards yet. So I could take the Acolyte here. I could have taken the last Acolyte, too. That was a consideration. But I think I want to just be, like, a beatdown deck. And, like, kind of ignore Adventures. But I'm not sure. I mean, I think either route would be okay. I think I'll take the True Love's Kiss here, since I know I'm white. Modo! Do you have artwork? Okay, thanks. Show. I mean, Paladin is, like, not a thing that I'm even super interested in playing, so I'm probably gonna leave that there and spec on, like, Forever Young or Treefolk. Our deck sort of wants to lean into Adventures. I have not had a good black-white deck yet, but that's on Arena. I don't know if that's a thing on... I'm gonna spec on the Forever Young, I guess. Doom Foretold. Ugh. I don't think this card is good. I don't think it's good. I'm not interested in it at all. I'm just gonna take the Squire. Squire is actually actively very good for this deck. Doom Foretold is questionable. I mean, it's fine. All right, Youthful Knight. It looks like mono white. Dang it. I don't mean to end up here all the time. It just kind of happens. I mean, it's strong, so I shouldn't even be irritated. It's a good deck. White has all the tools it needs to win. But it's annoying because I want to draft other stuff. Ugh. So, okay. I mean, I could have gone into Green White Adventures. I could have. But I don't think Wonder Mare is that good of a payoff. I don't. So I have zero regrets so far. Well, no, my biggest regret is not taking Sir Alan pack one, pick one. I should have. But then at the last second, I was like, take the bake. Okay. I'm stressing because Clackbridge Troll, I've never won a game with that card, which sounds so ridiculous. Every time somebody plays it against me, I like get smacked. But I gotta take it. I have to take it. I know. I do. But it's stressful. That's a reason to be black white. So Sir Conrad. All right, here we go. We're moving in. It's happening. I'm hoping to wheel out flank, but I doubt I will because this is the only white card in the pack. But this is fine. I guess this could be a good black white deck. I just need a couple like pieces of removal. Troll has been trolling me. I actually had an insane mono black deck on Arena. It had two trolls in it and a Murderous Rider. 0-3. I mean, that's best of one. That's a different story. But I've drafted Troll a good bit and I've never actually won with it. But I get crushed by it all the time. I don't know. We'll see. I think these are reasons to be black white, certainly. So now I just need a little bit more removal, and I think this deck will be fine. I'm not playing this. That's a reason to be black white. Okay, fine. Fine. I'm sold. Let's go. I could be greedy and try to wheel this, but I don't think that's the way. I'm not gonna play Griffin anyway. Let me get a knight count. One, two, three, four, five so far. I'm looking for maybe like eight knights. So yeah, if I get five more knights, this will be good. I mean, it's still a death touch. Like, I'll play this no matter what, but it truly shines in a knights deck. Go figure. You know? Okay, I gotta take the trap in the tower. Fireborn Knight is okay, but that's gonna be like tough to cast. If I was mono white, I would take that over the trap, probably. Maybe. Maybe not, because I don't have much removal. The card's very strong though. All right. I'm hoping like I can break the curse of not doing well with black white in this set. I've done well with white in every other color pairing. Green white, red white, blue white. But black white, I can't make it work. So this is like an experiment. Oh. Oh, these are so good, but I can't. That quad cost is, I can't do it. Like, there's no way. So I'm gonna take this and hope I don't have to play it. I mean, skewer might be a consideration, but it's pretty sketchy. I might need this, so I'm gonna take that. It's a knight. Oh, Belle of the Brawl. That's good. That's a knight. Fits curve perfectly. Okay, I'm into that. I'm very interested in the Foreboding Fruit too. And honestly, the Lonesome Unicorn because of Pathlighter. This is actually a little bit tough. Is Unicorn better than Belle in this deck? I would say at the moment, yes, because I don't have that many knights and I'm interested in an adventure card, but I think I'm gonna spec on the Belle and hope I can become more of a knights deck here. Okay. So, I think I want the Guide Mother over the Unicorn, but this is a knight synergy for Wintermoor and Belle. So that's, I feel like I'm losing out, but I think Guide Mother is just always so solid. Okay, here's the Unicorn. Thank you. I'll take this. Paladin is gonna be rough. I don't think I can play that. Outflank. Oh, the Outflank Wheel. That was the only white card in that pack. That's interesting. Is there a world where I'm not black white? Because I'm thinking about speccing on the Tree Folk, I guess. I don't think so. I think we're kind of in this now. It's a sideboard card. I should pass these. For signaling purposes. I'm not green. This is looking okay. That's good. Okay. Yeah, I like the unicorn a lot because it goes with Pathlighter for the adventure. Yay. And it goes with Wintermoor and Belle for the night. How nice. How nice. Sorry. Emery, you're beautiful, girl. I like two rare packs. That's fun. Not interested in any of them. I mean, I am. This was pack one, pick one. This would be a whole different story, but tactician is looking A-okay. This also is an adventure and a knight. How nice. Ooh, love struck beast. That's so good. Yowza. These rares that I can't play. Okay, it's, everything's fine. This is probably Flutterfox, maybe? I don't actually know, though. I don't. Flutterfox isn't good in this deck. All I have is trapped in a tower. It's just a bear. I'm sorry, honey. I love that card. It might be Carriage, I guess. Funeral's so rough. Eye Collector doesn't go in this deck yet. It's Carriage, I guess. I don't think I'm even playing it. It's good. I think this card is fine. But for my curve, I'm not really interested. I kind of just want these to be the top of my curve. Okay, I see these Rangers. So I think I could have done okay in Adventures. This is an easy trap, though. I just hope we don't play against white, because Guide Mothers are the key to getting out of the tower. So sad when you put a tower on something and the Guide Mother it, you're like, oh. Stressful. I guess I'm not playing Grange anymore. Carriage would be okay. The Paladin is going to be pretty rough because I think I'm 10-7 white to black because the black mana needs the double mana for black is late in the game. I could talk, I'm sorry. Okay, so this is a tough pick. Commander versus Trapped. If I didn't have two Trapped already, I think I would have to take this. But I think I gotta take this. If I had one Trapped, I think I would have taken the Trapped and like hope to wheel this, but I think this is too strong to not wheel. Okay, Ritual Zari. Guide Mother is perfect. Right, so what's my weakest card? I don't think I can play the Cottages. It's gonna be a 10-7 split, I'm pretty sure. Wow, that's a late Pathfinder. And a Squire. Ooh, okay. One, two, three, four, five, six. Oh, I think I just take the Squire though. This is tough. If I had a little bit more, like if I had seven or eight adventures, I would take the Pathfinder, but I think Squire is too good. Ah, that was a tough pick. I didn't like that. What? Why is this still here? Okay, I guess I'm never gonna play a Flutterfox, so I'm gonna. I hate it. I'm not gonna hate draft. This shouldn't be there, though. I respect you, Beast. This isn't a hate draft, it's a love draft. You shouldn't be there. I respect you. I'm gonna take you. Youch. Like, that is unreal. Green was not that open, I don't think, was it? I'll have to go back now. I think I'm in the right lane, but that makes me question some things. Like, what? What are you doing there? I've never seen that before. That was odd. Okay, so let me get a knight count. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Okay, that's good. So the commanders are looking solid. I know this is a sideboard card, but you can run it main. There's always something. So I feel terrible when I take it out because I think you can just run it and be happy. It might be Ritual, I guess, but with all these creatures, I think that's good. It's just hard to cut any of these creatures because they all feel like they're doing something. They all have a purpose. So let's run it like this. 10-7, I think. 11-6. In this economy? I gotta go seven. The double black makes me nervous. But it's late, so I think I can get away with that. Yeah, that's fine. This deck looks fine. I mean, two Archons is pretty nice and okay, my rares are good, all right? I got some good rares. Sir Conrad's a rare. An honorary rare. Try to say that 10 times fast. Conrad should have been a rare, so he's a rare. He's great. The troll's great. Archons are great. Got some synergies going on. Have some combat tricks. Have removal. I predicted 2-1 though. We shall see. Because stupid troll, I can never win with this card. Ever. Maybe today will be the day. I can't keep that. I can keep this. It maybe it should be Conrad, but I can cast things in my hand with these lands, so Conrad's so strong. I don't want to put him on the bottom of my library. Just hope I draw lands. My curve is low enough that if I get a third land, I think I'm fine. I didn't keep that first hand because if I draw one more land, I'm not doing anything. Like, this deck wants to curve out, and if I get flooded, I'm just dead. Sorry, I'm jamming, but y'all can't hear it because then it'd get muted. Nice. I can outflank that. Oh, not throwing back Conrad. It's punishing me. No. Yeah, I was definitely supposed to put this on the bottom. But I was greedy. I was really greedy because I thought, okay, if I draw lands, like later on we'll be able to cast them, it'd be great. If I hit a third land, though, I'm okay, I think. Outflanking that because I don't want to mess with the lifelink. Maybe they're stuck on color. I have traps, so if they play something and get it out of the way. But yeah, I would love a land. I was so greedy. Conrad, why are you so good? This is really greedy. To the max. I'm not trapping that. If they block here, I put a counter on that. That's fine. This does feel. I'm telling you, this troll. It always trolls me. Every dang time. Screw beats flood, though. If I hit my third land, I think I'm still in this game. But. Oh, I'm getting max punished. Big time. Gross. Super gross. So, I mean, I'm still getting kind of screwed here because I'm not hitting my second color. So, okay, let's say for 1 second I kept the land. I would have been able to have a 2-2 down. But this is still a problem. I mean, I guess I trapped this. It feels terrible. But they can't give stuff haste. Can't block. I'm over here just trying to get some stuff done, you know? I need lands. Big time. I probably get back the knight, right? Seems like good value. Yeah, makes sense to me. Could I please have a land deck? That'd be so nice. I would just love it. Ooh. That was a nice turn for them. Good job. Land? I need to hit land, like 3 lands in a row. I need 2 of them to be swamps. Easy peasy. Yeah. So I lose this game, which is fine. I'm on turn 6 with two. I would have had 3 lands if I hadn't binned one, but I wouldn't be able to cast anything in my hand. Them's the breaks. I'm playing like 5 black cards in my deck. Okay, maybe six with Bake Into a Pie. I think this is four of the six cards we're playing that are black. This is just unlucky. So I'll just play out the game, see what they have. It looks like they're mono black, which is fine. I think I can deal with that. But yeah, I mean, this, it happens sometimes. I used to get so mad. And I still, like, I feel like a little frustration, you know? Because I want to play the game. And this is not a hand I get to play the game with. But it does happen to everybody. So I'm trying not to waste, like, mental bandwidth or emotional bandwidth on getting frustrated about stuff I can't control. But it's easier said than done. I like to play Magic. Shuffler? Thanks! Okay. So, I think they just are sitting on removal. So whatever I play is going to get removed anyway. I'm not attacking with Belle. Need some, like, combat tricks for that to be a reality, so I'm just going to cast the Unicorn. If I can hit two swamps, I can get back in this. Or one swamp. Two more lands, I mean. What on earth could they have that would let that attack through Youthful Knight? Okay. The answer is nothing in mono black, right? Like, plus two, plus one, but that doesn't attack through that. No blocks for now. I could still win this game. I mean, Fairy Godmother is a card that could help me, like, close this out, but I do need lands. I could have just did that before combat. Ah, oh, Archon is good. Okay, so this is where I'm really feeling like bottoming that land. Because that would have really helped. But I am on turn 8 with... I could have had 4 lands. Like, it's... I'm still having mana issues, right? It's not good. But I'm feeling the mistake more and more as the game goes on. Sir Conrad's good, but, like, being able to cast your spells is better. Right? It just is. It's okay. It's only game 1. Live and learn. It's a thing I do all the time. I bottom lands, like, all the time. And then get punished for it. But then I bottom lands all the time and don't get punished for it. I mean. It is what it is. Sorry. So that Bognati's a problem. They only have 1 card. So I'm serious. If I hit lands, I think I can win this game. Troll is going to be helpful. But yeah, this is the ripple effect of a bad mulligan choice. They disconnected. Yeah. So, I mean, it's all just spiraling from that first decision, though. And I feel it. I'm sure y'all were like, don't put that land on the bottom. I thought it was going to work out. It's all right. I guess they reconnected. Let me see. Okay, cool. Cool, because I'd like to see this match out. Okay, so I'm at 16. I think I'm in defense mode here. I don't want to take 4, I know that. Okay, so I still wouldn't have been able to cast Troll, though. I'd be able to cast the Lonesome Unicorn, though, which makes a difference. So I can't play the Archon here because they're just going to kill it. So I have to be mana inefficient and play the Wintermoor, then pass, and then next turn play the Archon. I think I can get back into this, but it wouldn't need to be this stressful had I kept the land. You know? Here we are. But yeah, if I draw a swamp, I'm back in this 100%. But in my defense, I didn't know I was going to draw all my black cards, okay? Like, most of my deck is white, so I still feel like I'm getting a little bit, I don't know. It's just, it's unlucky. It's turn 9. I could have had 5 lands. Not great, though. I'm not sure why they didn't activate the Bognotti to kill something. Because they could have went like a little bit more aggressive here. They could have went on offense. They still can. I wanted them to kill something though so I could play my Archon. Can I please have a swamp? That'd be so nice. If I draw the swamp, I slam the troll. Ugh. Yeah, so I don't know if I like through this game or what, but the troll is definitely helping me now. Nice. I mean, that three life is huge. Okay, I can't really attack though. Not yet. Soon, once I get Conrad down, I'm gonna feel a little bit more comfortable, maybe. But yeah, okay, well, this game is at least interesting, but I made a very poor choice in the beginning. I know what I did, but I still stand by the fact, like, you're going to make mistakes in Magic. You have to figure out where to go from there. You can't just be like, bummer, like, I blew this game. No, you can recover from mistakes, but it just makes it harder for you. Just try not to make the mistakes in the first place, but... Your starting hand is, like, so important. Don't just throw back lands, because if you can't cast your stuff, you're in trouble. Sure. I mean, ooh. So I think I block the Wicked Guardian if they attack out. Mm-hmm. I'm still on the back foot here, like, big time. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. Okay. Yeah, I don't think I'm even gonna win with this troll. But we'll see. It helps a little bit. Okay, so six mana. I can't do two things. Let me see what I draw with troll first, because I think they tap it down. Maybe they don't. Yeah, see, now I don't have two blockers. So, like, I don't know how to win with troll, to be honest with y'all. So I'm taking three in the air for sure. This is going to be rough. I honestly, like, I've never had this do anything good for me. It's terrible. Like, it's giving me a hot second, but not much more than that. So I need them to have nothing. And I need to be able to block Barrow Witches with Sir Conrad. If they ever move on, I'm just dead. If they have another Swordmaster, I'm just dead. There's a lot of things that kill me here. What you got? Paladin? Okay. They can't attack with that. Oh, yeah. They can't attack with this. No! The drawbridge! So dead. Oh, the drawbridge. No! Super dead. Super dead. Yeah, because I can block... Here. Okay. No, I actually feel good about this because I deserve to be punished for that bad hand. Right? I do. Like, I made a poor choice and it, like, affected the entire game. So I'm okay with this. I take personal responsibility for what happened there. Had I had another lands, that would have been a different game. 100%. But yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I have 7 black cards and I ended up with 4 in my hand, right? The Troll, Sir Conrad, Bell, Winter Commander. So that just felt a little bit unlucky, but at the same time, I could have put myself in a much better position for that game. So yeah. Okay, True Love's Kiss kills the drawbridges. Do I care? I don't think in general I care. No. I think I just ran it back. Hope to make better decisions and draw a little bit better. That's all I can do. I'm on the play, though. This should be okay. Yeah, this is good. Not having to mulligan is nice. I appreciate that. Because a mulligan just gives you a chance to mess up like I did, and that's not good. But it's fine. This will do. One more land to get to Archon, so I can curve out nicely. I like it. If I don't hit my fourth land right away, having another knight isn't bad with the commander. I'm a little concerned I have a second swamp instead of a second plains, but all my late stuff needs double black, so that's fine. We're on game two. I'm pretty ahead on clock. Ooh. So I'm going to be able to outflank, but not this turn. I think I'm just going to play a Pathfinder and pass. I guess I'm going to let them get away with attacking. I'm going to block it. I mean, not block it. They're going to gain some life. I don't think I care about their life total so much as, like, I want to develop my board and then be able to outflank that at some point. I'd like if they just didn't attack. That'd be nice. They definitely attack, though. Yeah, no, I'm gonna hope that I draw a plains. Yikes, stop trolling me. Okay, I mean, I'm just attacking with the Pathfinder. I don't need to do this pre-combat, but I'm not attacking with the commander. So that's why I'm doing it this way. Sweet F6 value. It's addictive. I like to live on the edge and hit F6 as much as I can. They're tapped out. Like, you're not supposed to play stuff pre-combat. It's just don't. But there's definitely cases where you're like, all right, this is fine. And that was one of them. So I'll trade here. I want to pressure them as much as possible because I have the troll. But if I'm missing land drops, it's difficult. They might have Lash. Oh, wait, but that doesn't save it. So I'm fine with that trade. Wicked Guardian. It's pretty good. At this point, I'm trying to figure out if I'm going to play... Oh, that doesn't do anything. I mean, I guess that's fine. Missing lands hurts. Like, I wish that I didn't have to deal with this two games in a row. The first one was my fault, though. This one is just I'm not drawing them. We started with three lands. But it just makes decisions so much harder. I think I'm just going to cast this. And just attack with Pathfinder. And then trade here if they attack, take two. That's my plan. My real true plan is to draw land so I can play my stuff. But I don't have control over that. I just don't. So I think they're just going to repeat. I think they're going to play another Guardian and hit the Servant again and draw a card. Lands! I'm doing my land dance. Come on. A land would be so great. Oof. I love this horse, though. That is a nice-looking spirit horse. Okay. Yeah, having two swamps here feels bad, too, because if I had been able to use that flank as well, like, being able to double spell would be, it would do a lot. It would do a heck of a lot, but, oh well. What are you going to do? Attack with the thing I don't want to trade with and hope to draw lands. Ay, ay, ay. It's unfortunate. I mean, I have Death Touch, dude, so I can start making trades if I feel pressured. But their stuff is so small, I don't feel that pressure yet. I think I just slam the Archon if I get my fourth land, but... Especially, I don't know, I... See what they do. They don't want to trade the Servant? This is odd. Okay, I was going to say, this is an odd attack if they're just sending those two. I think I'm just going to make trades. Like, if I don't hit my fourth land, I just feel like I'm in so much trouble. I don't want to go too low here. It sucks. I hate it. But I feel like I'm on the back foot because I'm missing my lands. I just do. I can't help how I feel. That helps because now they have to pay to attack. I can't block anything with this, so it's going. Next turn, I'll have to fire off. I mean, I probably just play Unicorn, honestly. Because the troll's a liability. Like, it just is. I think they have Bacon to a Pie for the Archon. So I think I'm going to take 6 here. Okay, 5 is fine. So if I don't draw land, I get to hold up traps, and now Outflank doesn't even do anything. All their butts are too big. Outflank can kill that, I guess. I would love to slam troll, but like, okay, number one, I didn't get the land, so like that doesn't do anything. So I think I'm gonna trap the Hengewalker. And just pass. I mean, I guess I should have sent the Pathlighter. But it looks like I'm going to offer the trade here if I leave it back. But yeah, it's turn 8 and I have 4 lands. I just got my 4th land. I'm just kicking myself in the butt because I made a poor choice from the first game. And this would be so much different. Okay. I actually don't think I can take the damage from Servant. Is that insane? I don't think so, because I'm at 5, right? If I take this, and then this is going to be able to deal 3. So I think I trade off the Archon, which is like unreal to me, but I'm low here. And I just have to bank on hitting a land, I guess. I don't know. This feels so bad. No, I'm just going to hope I draw a land. I can draw a land. It's turn 9. I can draw a land. I can do this. Returning Swordsmaster? Swordsmith? I don't have any knights, so that's fine. I accept that. I need a land, like, right now, though. That's not a land. Oh, gross. Because I can't push damage here. Like, I'm so low. This feels bad. This has been my experience with black-white, though. It just never works for me. But this is unfortunate. It's unfortunate. Okay, so they play the knight. I'm dead, right? I need to trade off because now they play the other knight and then they throw the food at me and I'm dead. Yeah, I lose. Oh, no, not quite. Oh, boy. The Archon's helping me out, I guess. But I'm so far behind here. Mana Screw is so sad. I can't take damage, or I'm gonna die. Turn 10, I got my 5th land! Hell yeah! Alright, so Clackbridge Troll puts me at 8. But I don't even know if I can play it, okay? Because they can throw the food, so that's 3. This is gonna give Seth haste. So they have a 2-1 in their hand. This is always a liability for me. I have never, ever, ever had this card be good. Ever. I'm just too low on life. I'm just too low. And I hate it, because I want it to be good. But it's just never been good to me. Okay, I don't even know if this is good. I don't know. I don't know what to do. I think I'm just dead no matter what. I kind of need blockers, is why I can't play the troll, but... if they have two creatures in their hand, I'm just dead. I guess this is good if you can curve into it. But since it's turn 10, it feels terrible. Oh, no. No. All right, that's enough. They also have the Swordmaster. Like, I was dead in, like, 17 ways, but okay. I mean, you need lands to play Magic. So, that is what it is. The one was my mistake, and the second one was just not drawing them. I'm flustered. I'm definitely flustered. But it's something I'm learning, like how to deal with stuff like that. Like I take responsibility for that first game, and that doesn't hurt as much as like when you don't have control. But I mean, variance is sometimes in my favor, so I don't want to play chess. If I wanted to play a pure skill game, that's what I would do, but I don't want to. That's too much work. It's so hard to be the best at chess. It's really hard to be the best at Magic, too. But it's easier when you can play lands! Alright. This is an okay hand, I guess. Yeah, okay. This is a good curve. It's a really good curve. Let's start with Commander, I guess. I'm not really sure. Against White, I mean, they're probably going to play something that can block either one of these things. So I guess I'd rather lead with the Death Touch. So yeah, if I get my fourth land, this is actually a good hand. I'm going to try to leave the frustrations of the first match in the past. But it's hard not to take that forward. Like, when you have to mulligan again, you're like, ah, poor me, I've had to do this a million times today. Or like when you don't draw your lands a million times in a row, it feels bad. It's a feel bad. It's a bummer. They probably don't want to trade that. Maybe they do. In blue-white, maybe they do want to trade. I'm so attacking. I don't think they take this. I mean, I think they take the damage. I don't think... I'm shocked that they block. Because there's so many combat tricks. It's fine. I'm okay with the trade, though. They'll probably get some value off that, but... I'm shocked because I have squires. Okay. That's another thing I need to like stop doing is like, I don't know what their hand is. I don't know what their life story is. I know what I think is correct. But it doesn't mean they do. So your opponents will always surprise you. People don't play correctly. I don't play correctly all the time. But I'm very surprised they blocked that. Which, why do things surprise me anymore? I don't know. These are big questions today. I'm sorry. I'll just continue with the Magic. Sure. It says Menace. So we go in, play Archon, trap that in a tower next turn and play Youthful Knight. Seems good. I have a game plan. When I draw my cards, my deck works out just fine. If I draw lands and spells, it's weird that way. Uh-huh. Nice. Yikes. That's actually a yikes. It's not an activated ability. Okay. That's helpful. Okay, so trap this turn. Next turn, bake that into a pie. Swing six, play Youthful Knight. This is good. I can't complain about this game so far. Let it resolve! I like to play fast. I like to get my reps in so my opponents don't play fast. I get upset, but it's their prerogative. If they want to use all their clock, they're allowed to. All right. It's fine. It's a little bit irritating, but it's fine. So I have to bake. I'm still just baking the sage. Probably. If I bake the sage, I get in with Belle. Is that short-sighted? Maybe I just need to put the Archon back down. Yeah, I'm just gonna take a turn off from attacking. If their life total was a little bit lower, I'd maybe try to pressure harder, but I think Archon represents more damage in the long run. So, yeah. Sure. It's pretty good. Archon is also annoying because they have to pay to attack. Ooh, they're actually attacking. I mean, it makes sense. They have a lot of blockers. Okay, so I can bake into a pie the sage. I'm trying to think if I can do something clever here. If I send the bell and the Youthful Knight, I think they'll equip the carriage and then I can bake it. Well, but then they can still... I don't know, this could go horribly wrong. I'm assuming that they're gonna crew the carriage with the two mice, but that's a bad assumption. So I don't think I can try to be clever here. I wanna be clever, but I don't think it's good. Cause I don't know how they're gonna equip. Like, I know what I would do. I would equip the carriage and try to block stuff, but that doesn't mean the opponent's gonna do that. Okay, this says pro white, so it actually can't be blocked by the owl. So I don't know that I need to kill that yet. I'm trying to reserve this bacon to pie for something that actually needs to be dead. I don't think the owl is that thing. Still winning with Archon here. I'm holding up bacon to a pie. I should have just played the first part of Unicorn. I just don't feel the need to bake any of this stuff. I mean, maybe. I could kill the carriage, I guess. Just gotta pay. Yeah, I guess I'll just kill the carriage. Whatever. Take three. I have nothing else to do with this food, so I'll just eat it. Eat a snack. Okay, well, I'm already winning this game, so now I feel like the troll is just, like, gravy. They probably just scoop. This is the only time Troll has been good, and I'm already winning. That's actually pretty cute with the sage. Ew. Cute. So I have to try to find an answer for the troll. It's pressuring them big time, but giving them three goats to look for something is a kindness. This troll always feels like it's on the opponent's side for me. Hey. Hey, whose side are you on? Excuse me. Okay, cool. So attack here. That's all I can do. Next turn, double unicorn. I need them to not have anything for Archon. Enchanted Sleep is gonna be bad. But I guess the troll is a problem for them too. Ooh. Two sages is kind of cool. The problem is, okay, so I have them on all fronts, right? Like, they can't really pressure me because of Archon. There's two must deal with things. But they're cruising through their deck. I mean, if they could find an answer, there's the opportunity to. I mean, they're just going to tap the troll down again because they have to. I guess they don't have to. I'm just going to go to combat, though. I'm pretty sure they tap this down. Ooh, they don't. Okay. How does that trade? 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So I should have played this pre-combat, but I didn't. I wanted to see what they did. I'm not going to attack with troll. I thought they were going to tap it, but they do have a lot of toughness. I don't know if I want to show Sir Conrad. I'm just going to play two things. Play Connie next turn. Before I combat. But they do still have to deal with this Archon first and foremost. The Brute helps them a little bit, though, because they're actually at 5. Yeah, I mean, they have a lot of toughness, so not playing Conrad pre-combat there was a mistake. Ooh. Because now if they have a counterspell, I'm in trouble. So I think they have a didn't say please. They can't counter this because they die to Archon. They need to eat the cookie. So this actually can't be countered. If they counter it, then they lose. If they don't counter it, they lose. They're in a bad spot. It says pro white, so they're taking 3. Yeah. Okay, so they do have it didn't say please because they were starting to tap for it, I think. The old tap, concede. All right, True Love's Kiss, what do they have? I mean, I didn't see. Okay, they have all the glitters, they have a ginger brew. They have the carriage. True Love's Kiss comes in. What comes out, though? I don't know what I can cut. Maybe Forever Young. They don't have that much removal. Excuse me, that was a hiccup. Alright. Oh gosh, now I have the hiccups. No. I'm on the draw, so I'm going to give this a go. But I feel like this hand's going to break my heart. But any land I get to Pathfinder, I'm on the draw, so theoretically I should draw lands. Theoretically. I want to carve out. From time to time, I draw the appropriate amount of lands and spells. Ooh. That's a kissable target. Hey, broom, let me give you a kiss. Why you do this to me? Have to just cast this because, okay, I have a tactician, okay? I don't know if I'm gonna draw a third land. I don't know. You kidding me, though? Are you kidding me? Natural Bant on turn three? And an Oko? This is, I can't control this either. What? So he's like, oh. Thank goodness. Bye, Oko. It's been real. Get out. All right, that's nice. Now they have brooms for days. Not a fan. I'm not a fan. It's okay. I think I can beat brooms. I can't beat Oko. So, okay, no blocks, but I do want to outflank the adversary. Okay, I almost have six, so I was nervous. Okay, I can actually kiss the food so they can't sacrifice it. Is that a good play? They get to make one more broom off that. So I don't think I need to worry about that. Think it's just path later. I'm totally down for trades. Is this sage? No. Owl. Okay. Gosh, their deck though, it's so greedy. Okay, it's fine. Everything's fine. Oh, Archon, that's good. Okay, so they have an owl. I can kiss that owl. Don't have to do it right now. If I want to get in, I have to do it right now. Do I need to get in? Maybe. I don't hate this. It might have been better to take a turn off and play Archon, though. But since they only have Broom, I don't think that's insanely good. Ooh. I would like a swamp so I can kill that griffin. No. Okay. That's fine. So I want to be mana efficient here. This is pro white, so I could play the griffin to block, but I think they have some sort of removal. Oh, tactician blocks too. Right. Because the counter. Okay. This is okay. Everything's fine. Oko is in the graveyard. I accomplished something on this day. Even if I don't win this game, I killed Oko. I just see Oko and I'm like, why? Why aren't you banned in this format too, please? Please and thank you. I think they wait a turn to crack because they want to make a copy of the broom. Oh, okay. Or not. Sure. Troll be trolling. I'm in a fine position here, though. If I get my second swamp, I win this game, I think. If I kill that griffin, I mean, my air force is very strong, is what I'm saying. Especially if they tap out, yeah. The question is, do I troll first? No, I think I kill the griffin and get in the air. I mean, this is all I can do. I would like to not have land issues in the next match. That'd be great. I would really like that. That would make my day. Swamp would be amazing. A second Archon is not too shabby either, okay? If I'm gonna complain, it's not about this draw. This is a good draw. It's actually really gross for them. Okay. So I changed my mind. I actually think this deck is pretty good, but where the okay. That's a problem. That's really good with Sage. Oh my goodness. I've actually never had the opportunity to play these two together. That's awesome. But I guess we're having Vandalpie now. If I can get a swamp. I don't know if I can. Oh gosh. No, that's not nice. Okay. I need a swamp. That is huge. That's so good. Okay. I mean, I have Chompers for a little bit. It's not a big deal. But I would like my second swamp. I have... Okay. So there's 21 cards. I have 6 more swamps. I don't feel good about this. Not one bit. Not one bit. Their deck is pretty cool. But this is why I went 10-7. MTGO wanted me to go 10-6. I was like, no. I have double black. I mean, I guess they can't really attack, right? I mean, if they attack, that opens up a can of worms. Yeah, I want them to tap out, though, so I know I can kill the Vandal if I draw a swamp. The plan. Okay. Just remember that Archon has pro white, so you cannot use this on an Archon. Just throwing it out there. When I stream, people are like, use the Squire. No. Also, it doesn't do anything against an 8-9. Oh boy. That is really cool. I actually really like what they're doing over there, minus the Oko. I don't like that. But they were able to cruise through their deck pretty quickly with the two sages. Oh, here we go. It's happening. They didn't want to pay the one. Oh, they have to pay two. Oh, because Archons. Double Archon means you had to pay two. I missed that too. I was like, you just pay one. It's okay. Yeah, bye. I need to get rid of that now while they're tapped out. Okay, that's annoying. I've been got. They just mind gamed me. Maybe I should have played the troll first. I got. No. I was like, oh, they just can't pay for it. That's why. I mean, this is little again, but it can block the Archon, so that's annoying. I thought they were trying to attack, and maybe they were. They might have didn't say please. Let me lead with Unicorn. I don't like playing troll and open mana like that. They only have one card though, so it's probably safe. I should have just played the troll. If their last card is it didn't say please, then I just get got. They grow the Vandal by cracking the well. So I can't actually attack into that. They might get decked here. I probably should have slammed the troll with one card left. They probably didn't have a combat. I mean, a counterspell. I wonder if that's going to cost me the game. This is a tight game, actually. I mean... Okay. I just felt safe just saving it, because, like, how do they beat this? Double Archon is, like, the all-star of this game. I mean, it's just so silly. They have to pay 2 per creature to attack. That's unreal. So we're looking for Sir Conrad. That'll help me lock this game up. And, I mean, they're cycling through their deck, but they're running out of cards. I wonder if they have, like, a midnight clock. Because they're really cruising through that library. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Okay, so they have, like, 5 lands left. I think we've seen the majority of their deck. I don't think they have a win condition now to beat what I have out. But we'll see. Okay, they're letting me attack, which seems fine. Yeah, remember I can't use that on the Archons. I'm just sending the troll. And then hopefully they block so I can use Squire. Maybe I'm supposed to wait, though, because, well, I don't know. I think this is okay, but if I draw Sir Conrad, I'll feel sad. I hope they're blocking just to soak up damage, not to actually kill it. Then what do I kill? 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, so they blocked correctly, but I still think I want to kill a couple of things. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yeah, they blocked correctly. That's annoying. I can kill 3 things. That's my best. Right? If I use the trick. So 9, 10. Yeah, let's do that. It dies, but I take out their sage, so their vandal's not going to get bigger. Yeah, so now I kind of feel bad because, I mean, I don't know where Conrad is, though. Oh, they have a so tiny. Gross. Okay. Okay. I probably maybe should have thought about that because they did have cards and one island showing. It's fine. This is game 2, I think, right? They have 6 minutes left on clock. I think I win this game, naturally. They have 7 cards left, but I wonder if... I mean, they have to be feeling time pressure, definitely. And this is just tough. They have mostly lands left, I'm pretty sure, so I'm wondering if they have something... Like, if they must have midnight clock, the way they're aggressively going through their deck. I'm a little nervous. I'm a little nervous. I'm not gonna lie to y'all. They're crewing, but they can only send 2 things here. So they can only send 2 things, right? They can send Gingerbrute and Carriage? That's what? Okay. I mean, I'll just take 5. They're trying to end the game. I don't know if they can with 2 Archons out. I don't know if I can end the game either. Let's find out. Just cast all my stuff. I don't have good attacks because the Vandal... I cannot believe that Shepherd. That was amazing. Oof. Okay. I just don't see them closing this game out in 4 minutes. Not 1 damage at a time. I don't have attacks though. The Vandal is messing me up. So I just pass. Yeah, I just don't know how you win through double Archon. In 4 minutes. And then even if they win this game somehow, they can't get through game three. But I always try not to win on time. Like, I'm not trying to be scummy and, like, waste their clock. Like, let's see this out. But they are definitely way behind on clock. I would be impressed if they could somehow get through this. Maybe they have another all that glitters. That's my educated guess here, is they have another all that glitters and they're trying to get the brute through. But there's, I mean, I don't have good attacks. If that Vandal wasn't there, it'd be fine. Okay, Cookies, let's see if you can go the distance, bud. I believe in you. They're pressured on so many fronts, right? Like, they have 3 cards left in their library. They have 7 life, 3 minutes on their clock. I don't have anything to deal with this Cookie. I already used True Love's Kiss on the owl earlier. Oh my. Oh no, we're doing it. Okay. I was gonna say, I don't think they can do it because it just, they have to pay. Okay. This is actually close. It's turn 20, you know? Getting a little flooded over here. It's all right. If this Cookie wins, call me impressed. It's possible. But I can't attack. What's a good draw for me? I'm just a sitting duck over here. Because if I swing at the Archons, they block one with the Vandal, then next turn they block the next one with the Vandal, and then, like, I die. They're going to get there with this Ginger Brute. Yowza. I'm impressed. I don't have anything to gain life or to block that Cookie, so I'm... this is actually going to go the distance. They have 1 card left when I'm at 2, so... yeah, we lose next turn to a Cookie! That's fun. Then we would go to game 3. Ooh. Hmm. I might have... no, I didn't have lethal. They have enough flyers. Trapped in the tower right on time. Okay. Pass. Almost, Cookie. Almost. Oh. Run away together. Okay, now I'm at 2, but I think we have the blockers. This is at least interesting. I hope I get to line up blocks in this last minute. I don't think I'm dead. Because they have to pay for everything to attack. And they lose next turn, they have no cards left. You can't pay that much. Only 4 things can attack. Oh, no, no. I guess it's more. They bounce the Archon. Never mind. Just kidding. Okay. Hold on. I'm not dead. Pro white. Oh, I am dead. Ah, dang it. Because they bounced the Archon. Oh, that was so good. Dang. All right, we're dead, but they run out of time. They have 40 seconds for game three. That was pretty good. I mean, there's nothing I can really do. So if I was going to game three, what would I do? I don't think I would sideboard differently. Just the True Love's Kiss stays in. That last minute bounce was good. Okay. I mean, I would have liked to play a third game against that, but they ran out of time. And that Vandal was clutch. Okay, that was interesting. Wow. These people with all these trophies. I play mostly on Arena, so I'm over here with my four trophies. I play mostly on Arena. Because I stream. And people like to watch Arena because it's flashy. It is really pretty. The gameplay ends up being really different, though. This looks fine. Curve out, please. Okay. That's scary. Oh, okay. I think I play Squire on an empty board. Because Guide Mother feels like it's gonna help me out. Next turn, I can hop the Squire and play Guide Mother. Or I could play Tactician. Let me see. Ooh. Guide Mother might need to be used for tapping. That's pretty scary. I don't think I can race that, but I'm gonna try. I mean, they do have to tap to use it. It doesn't have trample. It's really nice with the lance on it, though. If they're tapping, I'm very happy. I'd rather have them not develop their board. They were thinking about it, I think. Ooh, gross. Oh, okay. I think I just swing in. And if they decide to block the Squire, then I will take my two for one to kill the Bell. Okay, they didn't. So I'm just going to tap on their turn. So does that mean I'm using the Squire? I think I'm just using the Tactician. I don't think I'm playing the Squire as a 2-1. They are a 10, so I was a little bit tempted. Oh, wait, hold on. Go to begin combat. Slow down over there. Thanks. Okay. Okay. So I like that a lot because I'll trap the Bell. All right, hold on. I guess I should attack first. Leave back the Squire to block the red cap once it's equipped. Is it it's plus two? Oh, it's plus two, plus two. Dang it. That was wrong. I mean, I might just... I'm gonna chump, I guess. Because then I have... Yeah, I guess chumping's okay. Because I have them dead in two turns in the air. If they have nothing. Also, the equip three is... Oh, wait. It's equip one for night. Dang it. Dang it. Why is this so good? Lance is so good. Oh. Okay. I'll just take three. That's fine. Forever Young, that doesn't do anything. Everybody in, and then the squire, when they block the squire. If they don't block, they're dead. I like that. Right, this isn't dead. Two, three, four, five, six. Yeah, I missed two damage earlier. So block, play the squire. This is fine. They have to deal with my flyers. Or die. I'll take that. Hey, I like when I can cast things. Okay, True Love's Kiss for the equipment. That thing's gross. I haven't seen removal for them, so I'm gonna take out the Forever Young. Skewer could be interesting, but I don't know. I think it's too slow. They're pretty aggressive. But so am I. I'm very scared of their deck on the play. This looks good. Just need a land or two, you know. Two drop, three drop, four drop. Five drop I can't cast yet, but maybe. Jousting dummy. Okay. Right. Swamps, and I'm in business. Okay. That's terrible. Gross. That's so good. So good. Stop. Make it stop. Yeah, because, like, do I have to two for one myself? Probably not yet, but I'm not happy about this. That's very good. Come on. This is not okay. Who let you have two lances? Yikes. Like, I don't even know what to do about that. I'm gonna have to block it, obviously. I have to double block. This feels terrible. But I can't just chump it. I don't like it because I mean the Archon's like great, but I don't want to die. And they could have plus two, plus two. Am I actually triple blocking this? Because if they have the plus two trample, then I just lose it all. I'm just gonna hope they don't have it. Yikes, that's not good with the lance on it either. Make it stop. Oh, this is so bad. This is where Troll actually might be okay. Save me, bud. I'm chumping? Question mark? I think so, because I think the troll gets me out of this jam. This Jimmy jam. Maybe not. I don't want to take any damage right now. They only have two cards. Okay. Okay. The troll. You're supposed to do something. You're supposed to help me. I need a baked into pie for that serpent. Ooh, they're gonna let me have it as a blocker? Okay, cool. I think I just play stuff and then hope not to die, you know? It's not my best plan, but it's a plan. It's problematic. I think they were supposed to sack something to get this out of the way as a blocker, but I'm glad they didn't. Oof. I think I go to combat. I think they sack this time because they see the error of their ways. No! This needs to be out of the way as a blocker for them. I would like to eventually hop it and win that way, but I don't know if I'm on that plan yet. I think I'm going to play Sir Conrad. I'm trying not to die over here. I'd probably just play Guide Mother, honestly. I think I win this game. I don't think I'm the aggressor. So I just want to, like, put blockers down. I don't know. It all feels bad. Ugh. The troll has actually done something good, though. I'm shocked. Am I actually the aggressor now? Maybe. I'll send the flyers. Play the unicorn. I'm just not ready to send the troll because I feel like they have so much damage and I'm really nervous. Fling. Youch. I think I just go with the flyers. Because I can't really swing into the Swordmaster. Because I don't have a good block for it. Actually, I do with the commander. I should have sent the troll there since I had this. But I think I can just attack in the air and win that way. Is that wrong? I think they should have kept tapping this because it represented more damage when they were able to attack. But I don't know. I don't know how to play this card, obviously. He's never been good to me, except for right now. So I have 7. Yeah. Put another blocker down. So they have a good knight stack, but I don't think they have removal. That's what was wrong with there. Okay. 2-1. I predicted the 2-1. I did. I said this deck's going to 2-1. I felt it. The first match, though, I'm telling you that was a bad mulligan decision, and then I got a little bit tilted on those lands. I'm working on it, y'all. I really am, but it's tough. Like, I like to play Magic, and when I don't get to play, I get sad or angry. I just do. So, I don't know. I'm working on it. That's all I got. But the deck was kind of cool. I don't feel bad about the 2-1. I'm sure I made some mistakes. I'm sure y'all will tell me in the chat, in the comments below. I like it. I learn a lot. Some things I just miss. So if y'all see something that you think I should have did differently, please tell me. I really do appreciate that. So Yeah, if you'd like to hang out with me live, I stream on Twitch at twitch.tv/JamieTopples. Come hang out sometime. I draft a lot. I'm really, really, really into Historic right now, though, because Kethis combo is my favorite thing in the whole world. I'm a degenerate. But it's so much fun. So I'm playing a lot of Historic, too. Yeah, but thank you for watching. I really do appreciate y'all spending your time here with me. Please hit that like button. Please comment, subscribe. Y'all are great. Have a wonderful day.